Now, in general, and you might have come across one or more of these examples, using randomness is, of course, quite important in computer science. You might have come across randomness, for example, in cryptography, where randomness is, in a way, the only way to fully securely encode a message. You might have encountered randomness in something called symmetry breaking. Let's say you walk down a hallway and somebody comes in your direction and you're trying to get out of the way of that person. But the moment that you get out of the way, that person also tries to get out of the way in the same direction. And so if you did not have random decisions, then you would almost certainly crash into each other. And finally, randomness is often used in simulations. So when you do physics simulation or financial scenarios, then of course also randomness is something very, very useful. Now, the difficulty with using randomness to solve NP-complete problems is this. In all of these examples here, being as random as possible is something rather desirable. So in cryptography, you want perfect randomness because that gives you the most security. Symmetry breaking works best if you have as much randomness as possible so that these two entities, say, will make completely independent decisions of each other. And in simulation, of course, too, because the point of using randomness in simulation is to simulate random processes. So you want to model that as good as possible. Now, for NP-complete problems, this doesn't work, because for NP-complete problems, we don't want perfect randomness. What we are looking for is a needle in a haystack, and finding a needle in a haystack simply by poking it from a few random directions won't really help. And that is why we need to direct our randomness. Let's say you use randomness in a very naive way to solve click, and just assign all of the vertices random values of 0 and 1. Now, let's say you're doing this for a graph with n vertices. Well, actually, I think you can answer this question if I give you 4 choices from which to choose. So is it 1 over n squared? Is it 1 half to the power of n? Is it 1 half times n? Or is it 2 to the power of n over n squared?